so this obviously isn't my usual setting. I'm not in Copenhagen right now. I've come home to Seattle for the holidays. To see my family and friends, and just spend some time for me, and relax a bit. And so far, it's been really nice. I feel a lot of positive energy from coming back home and being around the people I love that I don't get to see all the time like I used to. And I've always been kind of interested in energies. You know, we talked about energy when I was in martial arts. And since I've begun my transition, I've just kind of been... I feel like I'm more in tune with different energies in the world, or in my life, or that we can experience. So, and I should also mention that I'm a Libra. My astrological sign is Libra. And Libra is all about the scales. The Libra symbol is the scales. So Libra is always trying to keep everything in balance. And that very much describes me. So I'm always trying to keep things in balance, you know. Hard and soft, internal and external, mental and physical, male and female, whatever. I want to balance everything, work and play. And so I feel like with all this positive energy from coming home, that there has to be some negative energy to counteract it or to balance it out. And unfortunately, there has been. It happened when I was traveling. Now, I've been full-time for 6 months, and I do a lot of traveling for work. So I've been scared to travel dressing like this while still having my old name and my old photo on my passport. That's been kind of scary and concerning, and I didn't know what was going to happen when I tried to travel. But most of the time, it's been no problem. Like, I've had a couple of raised eyebrows, or a couple people that didn't even notice, and a couple people that just didn't get it, and I had to explain it. And that's been fine. Except this time, coming back to the States through immigration, I got flagged. So the immigration officer gave me this big red card that I got to, like, walk in front of all the other people waiting in line, like, holding this big red card as I was walking down to, like, this holding area. So I gave this officer my card. He gave it to an officer that was in the back room, along with my passport. And a couple minutes later, this officer came out and started arguing with this dude at the desk, because they obviously couldn't figure out who the fuck I was. And I had to go up to them and be like, I think you're talking about me. And they were just like, this is you? Really? 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 And I was like, yes, how many times do I have to say it? This is me. Please, can we get through this so I can go home? So this big officer comes out of the back room. He's like, come with me. So I go back into the back, into an interrogation room, right? Like ones with the one-way mirror and everything. And a camera. So I was videotaped this whole time. And this guy asks me all sorts of questions. You know, who am I? Where was I born? Where did I grow up? Where did I go to school? Who are my parents? What do I do for a living? What's my company do? You know, all these questions that I was like, I was totally cooperative, but still panicking, because, like, you know, what the fuck did I do? Like, did I do something wrong? Like, why am I being questioned like this? Like, take my documents. Here's my legal name change document. Here's my driver's license. Like, I'm an American, please. I'm not trying to smuggle anything in. I'm just trying to see my family. And it was really scary and really stressful. And so finally he went off out of the room into the hallway and left me there for a little while, and I could, like, hear them discussing, you know, about what to do about me. And, you know, finally they came back in and they were like, so how far along are you in the transition? Like, have you had surgery? And I was like, well, I don't understand. And he said, well, your driver's license says male for your sex. Is that accurate, or have you completed everything? And I said, are you asking me about my genitals? And he said, yes. And I said, I have a penis, if that's what you want to know. Like, why? And he said, well, because if we have to have you patted down when you walk through metal detector, we want to make sure that we have the right sex of the person patting you down. And I was like, whatever, I don't care. And he was like, well, government cares, so we have to know, blah, blah, blah. I was like, yeah, it's right there on my driver's license. What else do you want me to tell you? So eventually they let me go, and they walked me out of immigration with my stamp and down to the customs where I picked up my bag and then got flagged again and got to open up all my suitcases and bags and purse to show them that I just didn't have anything of interest, that I just had clothes and my Game Boy, like, seriously. And then I got a nice talking to from the customs agent who wanted to give me a hard time about how it was difficult for them to verify my identity, even though the guys upstairs in the interrogation room had just spent a fucking 30 minutes verifying my identity. Why does this guy who just wants to know if I am bringing fruit or meat into the country, why does he have to do it? Seriously, what is the big deal here? Like, if the system was fucking easier for me to travel with an F on my passport and a female picture and a female name, then I wouldn't be having this goddamn problem. So, excuse me, I get a little worked up, but I think that there's also something else on my mind, and that is that I've had more negative energy come into my life since I've been here in Seattle, just been a few days here, and that's been a conflict with someone else over YouTube. Now, other people, like Lady Vixen, who I love to death, have a very mature way of approaching conflict resolution. And the way I want to do this is to not reveal the identity of the person with whom I've had a conflict, because, to be perfectly honest, I don't want to give them any attention. But this person, I should have known this person was bad news, because the first correspondence I ever received from them started out with, I'm going to be perfectly honest, I have masturbated to Ron Mowenhalf, and I have these questions for you, and I would love to hear your input. And so I watched the videos on the channel, and I saw a person that was kind of in need of guidance, and so I thought I might try to offer some guidance. But it should have been a red flag, that first communication. And so I offered some guidance, and then basically this person took the words that I said and turned them around to meet their own beliefs and their own agenda, and furthermore, to use what I said to argue against the people that I actually agree with more than this person. So, you know who you are. You misrepresented me. You acted inappropriately toward me, and you insulted me. Okay? This person, when this person discovered I was angry, said to me, oh, come on, just admit it, that you'll always be a man that has this fetish of being a woman. And of all the reactions, about a million reactions cycled through my head in a split second of how to take this. And the only thing I really could do is just laugh, because I knew it was such bullshit. So I think the point that I want to make is that sometimes we have to meet conflict with something totally unexpected, like laughter. In this case, this person doesn't know who I am. I do. And no matter what they assert about me, it doesn't make it true. And you can't control everything, and you can't fight everything. So, might as well be able to laugh about things. And I think that positive energy of laughter will balance out the negativity. I hope. And I hope that I can actually live up to this philosophy, you know? Because it's the way I'd like to be, but I don't know if I always am. I won't know until I'm in these situations. So, that's all I have for tonight. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time, okay? More videos from Seattle coming. Good night.